After completion of security check, the truck will travel at a speed of 10 km per hour at the backside of the designated bay of gantry. At the backside of the gantry, there is a yellow-black zebra marking where the truck will stop. Once the truck will stop, the helper will get down from the truck and take out the fire extinguisher of the truck and placed at the designated place on the gantry so as any emergency can be handled with this fire extinguisher. Then the helper will guide the driver to place the truck safely on the designated bay. Once the truck is placed on the designated bay, the driver will switch off the engine and check the vehicle is in neutral condition. Then he will apply the handbrake. Once the handbrake is applied, he will ensure that cutout switch is off so as all electrical circuitry is off from the battery now. Then driver will come out from the truck. The first thing the driver will do, hand over the keys to the helper, because helper is on the top of the truck and now the control of the truck is with the helper, so as driver cannot move when the helper is on the top of the truck. Then driver will place the wheel choke at front and rear. After that, placing the wheel choke, he will ensure that earthing and bonding clip is attached on a truck body on a strip, unpainted strip provided on the body of the truck. Here is attaching the bonding clip before he has attached the earthing clip. Once it is done, he will ensure that master valves are all open and check the faucet valve that it is properly closed condition, so as whenever the loading will happen, no product should come out. After checking this, driver will go on the top of the gantry and assist the helper. Helper in the meantime will wear the safety harness. Once he'll wear the safety harness, he'll get ready to go on top of the truck using the swing ladder. He is disengaging the swing ladder and going on top of the truck. After reaching on top of the truck, he will disengage the locking rod of all the compartment and open up all the compartment. Once he'll open up all the compartment, he will open up the dip pipe cap, fill pipe cap and the vent pipe cap for all the compartment. Here he is opening up all the compartment. Now he will take out the dip rod. It is a very important process where he has to check again the emptiness of the compartment. He is applying the oil finding paste at the bottom of the dip rod and he is checking it. But this process needs to be done in presence of the operator or officer. Now you are seeing operator is there. He is checking the availability of any content inside the compartment. He will do this process for all the compartment. Once it is done, the driver will give the filling authorization note, fan slip to the gantry officer. He will record it to logbook and authorize them to load the truck. Then driver will help the helper to place the loading arm into the first compartment. Once it is done, at the time of placement of the loading arm in the first compartment, we have to make it sure the overfill sensor tube is going inside the compartment. Once it is done, he will place another bonding clip on the top of the truck, which is attached to the loading arm, and pull out the dead man lever. Once it is done, the driver will touch the touch key on the BCU sensor, so it will sense the touch key and communicate with the server to confirm the load number. Once the load number is confirmed, it will show the press acknowledgement button. Once the press acknowledgement button is pressed by the driver, it will again communicate with the server and show the first compartment quantity here and give a message to press the start button. And once the driver will press the start button, the loading will start for the first compartment. This needs to be done after confirmation of the first compartment quantity. The initial loading of the truck will happen at a flow rate of 300 liter per minute. This to avoid the static charge accumulation into the empty truck. Once the first 300 liter is being loaded, the flow rate of the loading will automatically jump up to 1100 to 1150 liters per minute. Here you are seeing the loading is happening at 289, 290 or 300 liter per minute, and once it is done, now you are seeing the loading rate has increased more than 1100 liters per minute. This is to avoid the static charges into the truck. And once the compartment, first compartment quantity is completed, the last 300 liter is also being loaded at a very low flow rate, which is up again up to 300 liter per minute, so as no product should spill out from the compartment. Here you are seeing again the loading is happening at a very low flow rate. So once the first compartment loading is completed, the BCU will again give an indication waiting for the load. And at that point of a time, it is communicating with the server for the checking the quantity of second compartment. In the meantime, the helper will close the deadman lever and using the 10 days so as no oil can drop on the top of the truck, he is using the 10 days. After using the 10 days on the loading arm, he will move the loading arm to the second compartment. Here you are seeing with the help of 10 days, so that all the oil which is dropping is getting collected into the 10 days. Remove the 10 days and put it into the loading arm into the second compartment, ensuring that the overfill sensor tube is going inside the compartment, and again he will attach the bonding on the top of the second compartment and pull out the deadman lever. Once it is done, the driver will press the start button and the loading of the second compartment will start. The initial loading again will start at a 300 liter per minute for the first 300 liter, then it will jump to 1100 to 1150 liter per minute. This process will continue for all the compartment, and once all the compartment have been loaded, it will BCU will ask for the seal number. Once the driver will put it into the seal number, it will again communicate with the server and it will show a message of disconnect, means the loading of the truck is completed. Now here the helper will remove the bonding clip and with the help of driver again put the loading arm on the loading arm cup. At this point of a time, helper is ensured the dip of the truck and the water available in the truck. So he has applied the water finding paste at the bottom and the dip oil finding paste at the top. He is checking, but it is not mandatory to check here in presence of the operator or officer. He is checking it for his own satisfaction. Now he is checking all the compartment. After checking all the compartment, he will close the dip pipe, fill pipe and the vent pipe caps for all the compartment. Once it is done, he'll close out the manhole cover. One thing is there is a one emergency stop button provided at the RT, remote interface terminal, RIT, to emergency stop. Here he has placed the loading arm into the designated plate and again engaged the locking rod for all the compartment. Now he has came out from the top of the truck using the swing ladder and removing his safety harness. Once he will remove the safety harness, like you see, he is disengaging the swing leader. Now driver will go to the gantry officer for registering his truck for completion of the loading. At this point of a time, driver will mention on the top of the fan slip he is satisfied with the loading and there is no water found inside the truck. Like he is mentioning the dip is okay and no water found. Once it is done, the gantry officer will register the truck and he will sign off for the final release of the truck. After signing off the final release of the truck and entering into the logbook, he'll hand over the fan slip to the driver. Driver will come down from the gantry and first thing he will take out the fire extinguisher and put it at the designated place of the truck because this fire extinguisher belongs to the truck. After placing the fire extinguisher on the truck, he will close the wall box and lock it properly. Here he is saying he is closing the wall box, removing the bonding earthing clip, and at the same time he will ensure that all the master valves are in closed condition and master valve box is closed properly. Once it is done, he will remove the bonding clip also from the other side of the truck. So now the truck is disconnected. At the last stage, he'll remove the wheel choke from the front and back. Now he's ready to move. In the meantime, helper will complete his all activity on the top of the truck and he'll come and hand over the keys here. Now at this point of a time, it is ensured that the helper is at the bottom. Driver will go into the truck, switch on the cutoff switch, start the truck, remove the handbrake and move out of the truck with the help of helper guidance. Once the truck is out of the gantry, the helper will climb on the top of the truck and truck will drive towards the exit gate at a speed of 10 km per hour for invoicing, locking and further dispatch to the designated retail outlet. I hope you like this video. Please do subscribe. Thank you.